The United Nations flag at the Uganda offices will remain at half-mast as the over 4,000 employees of the organization and Ugandans at large celebrate the life of Kofi Annan, a man whose legacy ushered in waves of realistic peace and conflict resolution in Africa and other parts of the world.
The first one is that he remains the only Secretary General who actually works at the UN. So he rose to the ranks, and as such, he's an inspiration that you can work in any part and actually make it all the way up to be Secretary General. Other words to describe Kofi Annan were, he was always calm. He was an incredible diplomat. He was very, very principled, but he was also very, very humane.
In the aftermath of the post-election violence in Kenya, Annan played the key role that led to a coalition government and a constitution that has propelled Kenya to be one of the best democracies right from the grassroots.
Annan, Mary Robinson, Madame Johnson Sirleaf, former president of Liberia, Groucho Marshall, among many iconic leaders, walked with us in the streets of Johannesburg, and we were all waving and chanting, peace for Africa, peace for humanity. And I saw in Annan the courage, the love he had for the continent. But what is interesting, the person of his motivation, his last engagement in Africa was his walk in the streets of Johannesburg in effort to promote Mandela's long walk to freedom.
He believed that we needed to engage. At that time, Uganda had issues, LRA, had all this going on. But he was a believer that Uganda could deal with that and could help with the stability of the region.
He was the son of Africa. So he is someone that I think all Africans should be proud of.
Annan was preparing to present 100 new ideas to sustainable peace at the United Nations later this month when he fell sick. The condolence book at the UN offices in Kampala will remain open for public signing until Thursday. Rebecca Emmanuel, reporting for Urban Television.